Hi guys, welcome back. So here in this video, what we are going to learn is how we can develop our own API with the help of RAML using Mulesoft Anypoint platform. And before that, we will see how we can create our online account for a Mulesoft platform where we can develop our own application or we can develop our own API, manage our APIs, publish those APIs to AppExchange, host those APIs into the cloud of worker. And then we will also see a basic walkthrough of all the components, what are all the components available for our Anypoint platform. And after that, we will develop our first a very basic API that will be completely built on using RAML, that is RESTful API modeling language. And we will be using API designer of our cloud-based Anypoint platform. And then we will after that, we will test our API, and after testing, we will deploy our API to the AppExchange, and we will also see how where we can find our API after developing that API. So let's start with the walkthrough of our application. And before going walkthrough, just let's create an online application, online account for our Anypoint platform. So to create your Anypoint platform, you just need to go to anypoint.mulesoft.com. So I'll just go to anypoint.mulesoft.com, and it will automatically append a login section here. And then you need to, if you have an username and password, you just need to go here, enter your username and enter your password, and you can click on sign in. Or if you don't have any account, you can just click on sign up here. So if you don't have, just click on sign up. It will ask some information like first name, email, phone number, what is the company you are working with, your username, password. And then you just need to click on this checkbox to verify the reCAPTCHA, accept the agreements, and then click on create account. So once you will create an account, it will ask you for, like, it will send you an email for verification. And I already do have an account, so I'll just simply go ahead and log in with my existing account. So after we will log in, this is the home page of our Mulesoft Anypoint Studio. So here you can see that we have different components. We have management center. Under management center, we have access management, where we can create our users, we can create some groups, we can get some audit logs, what are all the logs for our running application that has been generated. Under our API manager, what we can do is we can manage our APIs, we can manage our policy for our APIs, manage our SLA agreements for a particular API. So when we say that policies and SLA traffics, like how many number of API you wanted to hit in a in a single minute or in hour or in 24 hour of a time span, that you can manage your API manager. And using API manager, you can also deploy your API to cloud up. And then runtime manager is for managing all the applications that are running. Either it can be a flow designer application, or it can be an API that you have deployed to your cloud up. And then for the data gateway, you can access your Salesforce data with the help of Mule for connector that is provided by Mulesoft to access the Salesforce data. And then if you wanted to get the visualizing way of your application, you can use a visualizer for monitoring. You can use monitor, and we have some creating a public or secret keys. You can create this secret manager. And then in the left side, we have design center. With the help of design center, we can create our API, or we can create application with the help of Mule Flow Designer. And Exchange is the AppExchange, we can say. The Exchange is the AppExchange for MuleSoft. So if we take an example, that Salesforce had its own AppExchange, Google has its Google Play, iOS has their own Play Store for their application. So MuleSoft has Exchange, where we can download the APIs, or we can download the connectors, what are all there available. And we can also publish our own APIs, what we have developed, to the AppExchange. And then Anypoint Studio is a Java-based platform that we already downloaded and installed in our previous tutorials. And then we also developed a simple application. So these are all the components of our Mulesoft Anypoint. And these are all here. If you see in a pictorial way, we have Anypoint platform under that. We have design, And then we have manage for managing ingress for Anypoint, that is Anypoint Exchange. This is a runtime server that is Mule. And STL for holding the what are the data transformation what we are getting while we are executing our application. So these are all the same description that I told you, and this is the same picture that we just saw. So this is a very very basic introduction about the components of what all components an Anypoint platform do have, how you can create an Anypoint cloud-based platform account. So this particular account is basically valid for 30 days. So if you want to work after 30 days, your account has been expired, either you have to create a new account or you have to contact to Mulesoft support to extend your application trial account. So this is a very basic simple use case for the API. That what we are going to do is we will have a look in an API that is responsible for taking a phone number as an input, and it will tell us either it is a valid phone number or it is not a valid phone number, and in which country this particular phone number is being used, what is the carrier for that, what is the phone line type, that means either it is a mobile number or it is a landline or it is a toll free. So these are all we will get, and even we will also see if the phone number is valid or not. So let's do this without making any delay. So we have here, we are here. So what we need to do, you once you will get here, what you need to do is you just need to click on here, either this three dots on the top, and then click on this design center. So once you will click on design center, it will take you to your projects, what all projects you have created. So here I have created four projects that are developed by me. So to create our application, you just need to click on create, and then here you need to create API specification instead of create a new application. So we are going to create API specification. It will ask for our name of the application. So what we are going to do is we will say that phone validated, and we will use RML 1.0, and then we will save to design center, that is okay, and we'll click on create specific specification. So what before we go ahead and start developing the API that we are going to use is num verify. This is the API that we are going to use. So before creating this API, you can just go ahead to this URL numverify.com, and from there you can just enter your email. You can sign up for free, where you can get 250 API requests, and you can use. I already have an account. So this is my API key that we are going to use once. But if you see, this is a base URL for our application. So we are just going to copy this for now. That we will, I will show you how we are using. And we, these are the query parameters that we need to pass. One is access key, number, country code, and format. So all this, this is the format, this is the complete. If you click here, run, it will give you the output. It is saying that this is a valid true, and this is the complete URL. So if you see that this is our base URL we have, and then we have a validate as an endpoint, and these are all the query parameters. So what we are going to do is, we are going to implement all these using an API, so that no one needs to go here and develop their own APIs or access this own API. So what we are going to do is, so here if you see, we have this title phone validator, and even if when you enter, if you are here, you are getting nothing in a below section, but once you will enter, you will get a different things what you need to select. So in our case, let's say that we wanted to define the base URL of our API. So we already checked that base URL is this. So what we are going to do is, we are just going to type base, and it is asking for base URI. We just need to use this and this paste your URI, and then once you will hit enter, it is asking for security schema. So what is security schema? So let's say that some API is responsible for basic authentication, Some API is responsible for auth 2.0. So here we can define our, let's say that we just for an example. So here if you see, I type just name of our authentication as per, because I will be knowing which particular API we are going to implement. So this is just for an example to show you how security schemas you can define. So here if you type, it will ask which type of schema your particular API needs. So if you say that basic authentication, you can select and you can say the display name, and you can say that basic authentication, you can say description, you can say that API only works with basic authentication. So you can define all those things over here under security schemas, and then you can also define protocols, what protocols you are using. So we are using HTTP. We can define our protocol, because if you see here, we are using HTTP, we are not using HTTP secure. So we define this, and then if you have you can define the description, or you can say that if you have something, you can copy from here. So you can go to documentation and you can just say this is your description. So you can just copy this and you can paste this here for description. Whatever you will paste, you will see here, and you will also see over here what is summary, what is security schemas, and then you will get everything over here. Now let's say that you wanted to define here it has, if you wanted to define documents, so you can define documents, what is title. So let's say that a title is non-verify API, and then you have content, and you can say you wanted to just provide this link, so you can say that refer below doc for more information, and you can paste here. So here if you see, if you go here, you can see documentation and whatever the title you have provided here, non-verify API, and if you click here, you will get whatever you have provided here as a content. And then now if you have different things, you can secure by, you can traits, resource type. So here if you see, for the output, we are getting output in a JSON format, and we don't have anything how we are going to get all this information in which form. We don't have any object defined. So to define the objects for either input or response, what we can do is, we could just define here types, and under type we can say that API response, and here we can define properties. So what actually it is, types means what all objects our API is using, what is the object name, and what are the fields under that object name. So in the properties, we have a valid that data type is boolean, and then we have number, its data type is string, we have local format that is also a string. So we just need to copy and paste what all we have here, and we are just going to use this. So that we are actually, what we are doing here is, we are defining our an object, a custom object we are defining, like we do create a custom object in Salesforce with the help of their standard wizard, and here we need to define what all objects we wanted to. So here you can see that we successfully defined our API type. Now what we need to do is, we just need to define our endpoints. So because we have different endpoints, so in our case we have only one endpoint that is saying that validate. So what we are going to do is, we'll define our endpoint. So for defining our endpoint, just put a forward slash, put a name endpoint, whatever it is, and then put a colon after that. And then after, you just need to hit a space, and then in here you will get what method you wanted to define here, what is and whatever the display name, description, what is the types. So here, as we know that this is a get method, this is a get request that we are making. So what we are going to do is, we just need to select get, and inside get, as we have query parameters. So if you see that we have different query parameter, access key, then we have number, we have country code, we have format. So this is what we are going to define these query parameters. So we will say access key, which is type of a string, and we have number, that is also type of a string. We have country code, that is also type of a string, and we have format, that is a string. So why we are defining all this? Because these all are the query parameters required in our API. So here, if you see in the right side, you are able to get this, what are all the types. That means your types means what are all the objects you do have, what is the security schema, what are the documentation, and what is the endpoint that you have created, validate, overview, and get. So here, if you click on get, you will see that these are all query parameters that are required. We don't have any example. This is the example that it does provide, how you can make a callout for that. And here you also have a button for trying this, for testing our API. So we have done this. Now what we need to do is, we can define our display name. What is the display name? We can say that description. So we can say that for validating the form, we can also define display name. So we can say that validate phone. We can define protocols. We already have HTTP, and then we need to define responses. So we need to define response. Response means status code, as we have a 200 status code, 201, 400, 403, 500, 501. So all these responses. So what we are going to response as a 200. So we need to define all this body. And because our response is as an application JSON, as we already saw here, as an application JSON we are getting, we will giving the type. So which type we are getting the response? We are getting this as a response. So here we are going to type as a API response. And then we need to provide an example here. And for example, we can just copy this particular piece of information and paste here. And then select this and just, so if you see that now here, if you see, if you go to click on get, you will see that you have responses for 200, and here it has example that if 200 is, and it will give you a response like this. Now we need to we need to do the response for 400 as well. Why it's not giving us? Okay, so we will give the response here, that this will be 400. We're selecting this, and for body we will be selecting an answer will be application by JSON, and here we will define a property, and we will be message, and which will be type of string. So why we are defining a property here itself? So that we can give a random message for our. So here what we are going to do is, we just put an example here, and we will say that message equal to API key is invalid. So even if you wanted to define some more responses, like you wanted to define 403, you can response like that, and you can define whatever all the responses you wanted to define there. And you can say the properties, you can say that URL resource doesn't exist, So this is how you can design your first API. So if you see here in the right hand side, you have a document proper. What is the summary, whatever you have given here, what is the base URI, which protocols it supports, what are the API endpoints, and then what is the documentation for that, what are the objects this particular API is using, what is the security schema. And now for testing, as you can see that we have this mocking services, you just need to click on this and it will give us a mock URL here, and here it will also change the base URI if you see. And now you just need to click on get, then try it. It will ask for access key, so you just need to provide our access key. It will ask for numbers, so we just need to provide a dummy number here. Country code we can say US, and format we can say 1. So why we are giving format as a 1? So if we will give format as a 1, we will get the response as a JSON. And if you are not giving format as a 1, then it will not return a format, it will not return in the form of JSON. So here if you send data, you can see that it is a true and okay, and we are getting this particular response, whatever the example we have set here. Why we are getting this? Because we are mocking services, we are testing with the mock services. Now if you click on this again, this API will get changed, this request URL will get changed. And then if you now click on send, you will get that it is saying that valid is false. Why? Because this is not a valid number and we are getting line type null. Now if we remove this particular one, now click on send, you can see that 200 okay and we are getting valid as a true. So why this particular, why earlier it was not able to get the valid result? The reason was we are giving a country code here. So if you are giving a country code, it is already appending that country code before that number, and in this number we already provided that country code. This was the reason it was giving a valid as a false. So this is how you can develop your own simple basic API. So it has multiple things. Here in the get parameter you can say that this particular authentication you wanted to secure this particular request. So if you see that I have just given secured by as a basic, and now if you click on here validate, it will now ask for a username and password, because this is a basic authentication. You can see it is asking for username and password, and even if you provide one more security schema, let's say that you are providing path 2 and you are saying type as a path 2.0, and you are just you don't need to provide this, you have description, you can say that path 2.0, or you can say display name 2.0 here. So once you are done with this, now if you put here other auth 2.0, then it will ask for a client ID, client secret and all. So if you click on here try, you can see it is asking for grant type, which particular grant type it is, what is the client ID, what is the client secret, what is the redirect URI, and then you need to request access token, and then you need to send. So this is how this particular RML works, and this is a very good, we can say that this is a very easy way to develop your API and distribute your API with the help of Exchange. So now you as you have developed this particular API and you wanted to publish this API to Exchange, to the Anypoint Exchange, what you need to do is you just need to click on this publish to Exchange. Once you will click, you can see that it is asking what is the name, what is the file that you, what is the RML file that we generated. So here you can see that this is the right, what is the version and what is the asset version. So once you will click on publish, it will publish your API to the Exchange in a private mode. So if you see that successfully published to Exchange, and you just need to click on Exchange and it will show you your API. you just click on done here, and you can see that this is a phone validator, and there is nothing. In the right side, you can get all the information, the person who developed, what is the visibility, when it was getting published, who was the person, who was the author, what was the organization, what is the type. And here you have mocking services as well. And in the left hand side, you can see you have summary of your API, what you have done over there, what are the endpoints, so you can see validate, and then you have get. What is the documentation for that? What is the types? What are the API stances? So even here you can also validate this. So here you can see you have mocking services, you have API based URL. So if you see mocking services, the URL is different. If you see API based URL, specs based URL, that means the base URI that you provided, this URL is different. And here you can provide the information and send, and you will get the information. So even I will test this once for you as well, from here as well, from Exchange. So here you can provide, we have a number, we can give this number, and we will remove a one. And for country code, we will give US, and for format, we will give one. And once we will click on send, you can see that we are getting validated as a true. Even we are using the API based specific URL, and you can see that the API URL, that is the complete URL, which needs to be sent to the server in order to get the validation. And even if you, let's say that if you are making changes, you are clicking this, you are getting 200, but the validation is false. What is the phone number you are validating? Validate, that means it's not a valid phone number. Even if I try to validate my phone number, and I'm giving country code as India, and you can see that it is saying the valid is true. What is the number? What is local format? What is international format? Prefix, country code, Indian Republic. And it is also showing where it is associated, what is the location, what is the carrier, the company, I'm using a mobile, what is the line type, and it is a mobile phone. So this is how you can just develop an API, publish an API. So this is it for this session. In our next session, we will see how we can publish our API to the cloud hub, and how we can define SLA and and proxy for our. If you have any questions, just write down under the comment section of the video. Thank you. We will see you on next session.